morning. Good morning and welcome to this Palm Sunday worship service here from Jerusalem Western Salisbury Church, Allentown, Pennsylvania. We welcome all of you gathered here in the sanctuary, and we gather our friends who are coming to us online and seeing this service, both live and perhaps after the service. We give you warm words of welcome. This is our practice, or becoming our practice anyway, please join with me in reciting our statement of purpose found on the top of the announcement page just inside the cover of the bulletin. To welcome all people, share Christ's love for one another, and help to make Christ visible in daily life. We hope that that becomes true, that is true, and continues to be true as we strive our best to serve our Christ in the world today. There are prayer concerns listed there, as always. Please pray for them. Continue to pray for them as you go, not just today, but in the coming days and week. I know that prayer works and that they appreciate that very much. I was just looking really quickly. One update for everyone. Bishop Christopher DeForest, who is the Bishop of the Northeast Pennsylvania Synod of the Evangelical Lutheran Church, is doing amazingly well. He's extremely healthy. He's lost a lot of weight and is grateful to God, and that's what I'm thanking you for, all of the prayers. He sent out a special thank you on Facebook this week with this huge conference table full of get well wishes that came from all of us, and he asked if I would pass along to all of you thanks for the prayers and any other greetings. He is doing much, much better. He still has some back pain, but his new heart valve is working better than ever, I think. And he looks healthy and is back to work. So we're thankful to God for that. Just a note, our emphasis on the emergency evacuation plan that's here in the bulletin. You can read that. Just be aware of where you can get in and out of the building should that need to happen. In other announcements, our yoga continues on Mondays at 11:30 in the chapel, led by Emma Cordes, and you're welcome to come there. You can read all the details about it. We're always looking for bulletin and flower sponsors. And we're constantly collecting non-perishables to the food bank. You can read about those also there in your announcements. Palm Sunday marks the beginning of Holy Week, and just so that you know all the things that are happening here at Jerusalem Western Salisbury Church, Good Friday, the sanctuary will be open from 12 noon to 3 p.m. For quiet prayer and contemplation if you choose to come. Also, on Maundy Thursday, there will be a service in the evening at 7:30 at Christ Lutheran Church with worship of Holy Communion and foot and hand washing, and I'll be a part of the leadership team from all of the various churches for that service. Then on Good Friday, there will be a service at 7:30 p.m. at St. John's Lutheran on 5th Street, a full tenebrae service. There's choir in both of those, and it should be a wonderful and beautiful time with the Allentown Collaborative Ministries working together. And likewise, an Easter vigil at 7:30 p.m. on Saturday evening, and that one ends with champagne at the end. Breaking the fast with champagne reception. And then, of course, all of the services coming up next Sunday, Easter Sunday, here at Jerusalem Western Salisbury. We're privileged to gather at 6:15 in the morning, with sunrise scheduled at 6:32 or 6:33. We start in the dark and end in the light, and you're welcome to come. Our friends that play wind instruments will be there, too, outside. And then if it's cool like it is this morning, you get to come in and have some fresh, hot, sticky buns and coffee and fellowship in the building immediately following. We also, of course, will have 9:45 a.m. worship with Holy Communion with the brass, choir, and hand. high sale in May. You can read that information. And more presently, the Joint Board Council Consistory and the Choir are sponsoring a fundraiser for the James Lawson Freedom Schools 2023 for the ham and cheese sandwich sale. So you can see the order blank. Those orders are due next Sunday, so make sure you get enough for the whole family. Let us now prepare our hearts and minds to worship God. In the name of the Creator God, and of the Redeeming Son, and of the ever-present Spirit. According to Matthew, chapter 21, verses 1 through 11, how our Lord entered Jerusalem. When they had come near Jerusalem and had reached Bethpage at the Mount of Olives, Jesus sent two disciples, saying to them, "Go into the village ahead of you, and immediately you will find a donkey tied at a colt with her. Untie them and bring them to me. If anyone says anything to you, just say this, 'The Lord needs them,' and he will send them immediately." This took place to fulfill what had been spoken through the prophet, saying, "Tell the daughter of Zion, look, your king is coming to you, humble and mounted on a donkey, and on a colt, the foal of a donkey." The disciples went and did as Jesus had directed them. They brought the donkey and the colt and put their cloaks on them, and Jesus sat on them. A very large crowd spread their cloaks on the road, and others cut branches from the trees and spread them on the road. The crowd that went ahead of him and that followed were shouting, "Hosanna to the Son of David! Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord! Hosanna in the highest heaven!" When Jesus entered Jerusalem, the whole city was in turmoil, asking, "Who is this?" The crowds were saying, "This is the prophet Jesus from Nazareth in Galilee." "Hosanna to the Son of David.
Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is the one who comes from in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna in the highest."
Mm-hmm. as we bless the palms, we praise you and thank you, O God, for the great love by which you have redeemed us through your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. On this day, Jesus entered Jerusalem in triumph and acclaimed Son of David and King of Kings by those who scattered their garments and branches of palm in his path. Bless these branches and those who bear them, that we may ever hail Jesus as our Lord and King and follow him with perfect confidence. Through the same Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Holy God, we confess to our faults
and grace.
Too often we neglect
and
do not trust your holy word.
We take it for ourselves instead of giving to others. We spoil rather than steward your creation. We cause hurt through no cause to heal. You choose fear over compassion. Forgive us, renew us, and lead us as we seek to follow you.
Hear the good news. God so loved the world that God gave the only Son so that all may receive life. This promise is for you. God embraces you with divine mercy, forgives you in Christ's name, and revives you in the Spirit's power.
Amen.
Thank you.
everlasting God, in your endless love for the human race, you sent our Lord Jesus Christ to take on our nature and to suffer death on the cross. In your mercy, enable us to share in his obedience to your will and in the glorious victory of his resurrection, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Whether you remember this Palm Sunday story or are hearing it for the first time, This story, all about Jesus entering the city of Jerusalem, the holy city, where what will be the last time before he dies, is a dramatic story that holds our attention. All those there at the parade watching don't know yet that Jesus will ride on to die, as it says in the hymn, but Jesus knows. After causing all sorts of talk and trouble with his teaching, Jesus also caused concern and fear among the religious leaders and authorities of the temple because of the reaction of the crowd and how much they liked Jesus. The occupying Roman government clearly viewed Jesus and all of his followers as a threat and a challenge to their power and position and place in the society of this occupied land of ancient Israel. The crowd was yelling, "Hosanna! Hosanna! Hosanna! Hosanna in the highest! Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord." At first look, the parade looks like a celebration. Parades are celebrations, right? And it is a celebration in part. At first look, everything we thought we knew about Palm Sunday was that it was a happy time. A deeper look says it is more than just a celebration. The word Hosanna, the crowd is yelling, seems to be another word of praise like Hallelujah. Well, I'm not supposed to say that during Lent, right? No, sorry. It might seem that the crowd is shouting that Hallelujah, 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 as in God be praised. But instead, they're shouting Hosanna, 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 Yahweh God save us, rescue us, save us, Jesus save us, rescue us. Remember, many of these followers of Jesus who were gathered there in Jerusalem to welcome Jesus, shouting Hosanna, 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 were expecting a revolutionary figure, a soldier, a general maybe, a fighter anyway, who would come roaring into town in a fancy chariot, ready to fight with all kinds of power and take over, come rushing in on a chariot as if ready for war. They were hoping Jesus would kick the occupying Romans out and give them back their country. It's important for us to carefully remember, too, that we know the end of the story. We know that it all ends with Jesus' resurrection, don't we? So therefore, we have the perspective of viewing the whole thing through this knowledge of the coming empty tomb. Instead of total despair, we are instead able to solemnly remember and give thanks for Christ's suffering, dying, and rising that is coming in Holy Week at Easter. This realization keeps our impatience and our fear and our feeling of loss under control, kind of. A very different feeling from the way those who witnessed the parade must have felt. They put their palm fronds and their cloaks on the road as Jesus passed by. It was different than what they were feeling. From the Mount of Olives to Jerusalem, they praised him on Palm Sunday. They thought the Savior had finally come. Their Savior had finally come. And then, just a day or two later, for all kinds of reasons, including fear that their own lives were in danger, these same followers turned on Jesus and yelled, "Crucify him! Crucify him!" But I'm getting ahead of the Palm Sunday story. Let's take a minute and set the stage. The exact location where this parade action takes place, the Jerusalem suburbs of Bethpage and Bethany, at the place called the Mount of Olives. These days, there's a high hotel on the top of the Mount of Olives. The Mount of Olives is one of the hills surrounding Jerusalem, overlooking what is known as the Kidron Valley. And then, on the other side of the valley, is the ancient holy city of Jerusalem, up on another hill. So you go down into the valley and back up and go into the holy city. When you come down the Mount of Olives on the Palm Sunday road, as Jesus did, on his way back up to Jerusalem, and down in the Kidron Valley, then you must go back up. Like I said, Jesus took this trip on a donkey. not in a powerful chariot with a spear in hand, ready to encounter anyone who tried to stop him or block his way, but in a gentle donkey, a colt, tells us. The scripture, in fact, tells us that as Jesus prepared to re-enter the holy city of Jerusalem, two disciples were given instructions. It says in the scripture, go into a nearby village, and as you enter it, you will find they tied there a colt that has never been ridden. Untie it and bring it here. If anyone tries to stop you, simply say, our Lord needs it. You see, Jesus prepared every detail for this parade in the city. Jesus even gives them a script with exactly what to say. Every little detail is covered. Jesus specifies exactly what type of colt he wants. The exact one, in fact, one that had never been ridden. Jesus gives them the exact location of that colt. Jesus told them exactly what to say, even how to talk their way out of getting caught, borrowing the colt. When Jesus tells them, just say, the Lord needs it. In hindsight, it seems the disciples perhaps should have known that this parade was also a kind of funeral procession, because Jesus was coming to Jerusalem to die. Jesus predicted it. Old Testament prophets told us about it. These disciples never seemed to really understand the meaning of all that Jesus was teaching them. And these disciples didn't seem to catch on until after Jesus' death. It wasn't until after Jesus' death that these disciples really started thinking about all that Jesus had said to them, and all that Jesus taught them, and all that Jesus did for them. It's still true today. So often we do, all of us, who say we are followers of Jesus, you know, all of us who call ourselves Christians, we tend to forget, or maybe ignore, what Jesus teaches, and think that all of us have all the answers. But here's where I think that so many things in all of our lives right now today, these extraordinary times, Palm Sunday is totally different again in 2023. When you think about it, I believe our world continues to face some of the most unique challenges the world has ever known. At this point in the sermon, I said, so, okay, what do we need to hear today? What is the message that I'm trying to bring? One pastor tells us that we need to think about the use of the word Hosanna in this story. He says, you got to admit, this is not a term that comes up in everyday conversation. If you're like me, the last time you uttered Hosanna was, well, last Palm Sunday. It's a peculiar word, one that is difficult to define, end quote. And this preacher is exactly right. Scholars' best guess is that Hosanna is a contraction of two Hebrew terms, yashah, which means to save or deliver, and naw, meaning beseech or pray. Yashah naw, or as we say it, Hosanna, save us, we beseech you. Ask and we pray to you. So you might translate the shouts of the crowd as Jesus entered as, we are almost begging you to deliver us, to save us. The people cheered. They tossed their branches from the nearby palm trees to the ground, and they called out Hosanna. They watched as a prophet named Jesus, who was rumored to be the Messiah, paraded by them, and they cried out again, save us, Hosanna, save us. So perhaps the meaning of Palm Sunday hangs on those two words, save and us, on that simple plea, save us. The Palm Sunday parade was as much a peaceful, nonviolent protest march as it was a celebration. Do you feel? Do I feel compelled on this day, on this Palm Sunday, to shout, save us? To shout, save us to our God as we prepare for Holy Week? Do you think we need to be saved? I know, another statement, right? as we continue to wave our palms. Go ahead. Hosanna, save us. Hosanna, save us. We boldly cry out, Hosanna, save us. Can we dare and imagine what we are really asking God to save us from? Or want to ask, what, to ask God what to save us from? We ask God to save us from fear, save us from anger, save us from depression, save us from being in debt. Hosanna. Maybe it saved me from strife in my family, or save me from boredom, save my children from being afraid to go to school, save me from loneliness. Save me from myself. Hosanna. Save me from staring at the ceiling at 3 a.m. wondering what's next. Hosanna, save us. Save me from bitterness. Save me from arrogance. Save me from selfishness. Save all of us. Hosanna. Save me, God. Save me from all our fears. Save me from my fears. Oh God, oh dear God, we humbly pray. What does it look like to be saved by God? Tough question, right? I know, it's also an understatement, isn't it? It is all about the God within us part. There it is again, right there, in old letters, Emmanuel. Another name for God, which means God with us. A God who is not only with us, but stays with us in good times and especially in those messy or tough times when we need God to be with us most. With us to save us. Thanks be to God. Quoting my preacher friend again, I've got to believe that this is in part how God saves us. God doesn't send a text message in from some suite in heaven's Ritzy district. God comes. God incarnates. God takes on human form in the person of Jesus. God steps out of the grandeur to stand with us in awkward places at awful times to experience life and death. God answers our cries of Hosanna in ways so utterly unexpected that we have got to look a second time to see they can possibly be true. End quote. So, as we begin the transition from our Lenten preparations, moving from Palm Sunday to Holy Week to Easter, is there any better way than with these palm branches in our hands and loud shouts of Hosanna, save us. Hosanna, save us. Like I asked twice before already, do you think we need to be saved? Oh boy. Let us pray. This closing prayer comes from the Church of Scotland, written for this day, this Palm Sunday, 2023. Written for this day of the palms and the day we begin to encounter the passion of our Lord. Let us pray. God is good. The way ahead is ready. Christ is ours. The truth is there to follow. The Spirit is with us. New life is offered now. So go now, in the goodness of God, to walk the way, in the presence of Christ, to follow the truth, in the embrace of the Spirit, to accept new life, and be blessed, and be blessed, and rejoice. Amen.
Please join me in affirming our faith using the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth.
I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again.
Dear God, today we remember Jesus' journey to the place where he would be challenged by the naysayers. He rode on the back of a donkey with people laying palms before them as they traveled their way to a difficult loop ahead. Help us all to remember their journey as they neared the site of his demise, but especially help us to recall the remarkable feelings of Easter morning when the past was behind them and Jesus was resurrected. We know the resurrection is what it's all about. And we thank you not just for saving, for sacrificing Jesus, but also for the blessings of forgiveness of sins and eternal life. Amen.
We are indeed fortunate and blessed each time that we gather to be able to give back symbolically in a special way. And we do that each Sunday, we do that today by bringing forth our tithes and our offerings. sending a benediction. We give thanks to God for the gift that we've been given by our musicians, Dr. Ad and Markel, and the wind ensemble. It so enhances our worship and makes it celebratory, and we give thanks to God for all of your offerings to us this day and each time that you play. Now we will set aside our palm branches. Now we will pick up our cloaks and follow Jesus wherever he leads. Now we will sing songs of wonder
as we work alongside the Spirit, sustaining the weary with peace and hope.
And as you go, may the Lord bless you and keep you.